Hi, this is Steve Westmark, Council of Realty. Thanks so much for watching my video blog this week. This week I'm going to share with you the 10 red flags that a buyer should look at as they're looking to purchase a home. Not always will all 10 fit in, but it's things to look at. The number one flag to look at is the neighborhood. Every house is in a neighborhood, and as you drive the neighborhood, you want to look around the neighborhood to see what does it have. What does it have for shopping, for schools, for safety, and also look around the surrounding houses, how they're maintained and taken care of. The second flag you want to look at is as you walk through the house, is the house a fixer-upper? And if you're not one of those types of people that knows how to fix up, you may want to make sure that you have a good handyman that comes along and gives you a good idea what it's going to cost to fix up, or move on and look for homes that have less things to be done with them. The third thing that you want to look at is the area of home inspection, and you want to be able to, as a red flag, get an inspection done. They usually run about $300 to $400 to have a full inspection on the property, but it does point out things that you do not see as you're walking through. They may be looking in attics, they may be looking around closets in basement areas, but they will also look at mechanicals and appliances and warn you and show you things that could be red flags for you as a buyer. The fourth thing you want to look at is additions and decks. And as you walk around the property, especially on decks, was this a homemade deck or does it look like it was done by a contractor? The do-it-yourselfers sometimes with additions and things like that, you may be running into a problem if you buy a property that has been done by a do-it-yourselfer. Number five is the area of looking at structural problems. And you're going to be looking closely at the foundation, especially when you go into the basement or garage floors and things like that. You want to look for the structural problems that the property may have, and this makes a lot of difference as you're purchasing a property. Number six that you want to look at is for pest damage. Pest damage can come in and cause a lot of problems, whether it be rodents, whether it be other types of things. In fact, the wildest one that I know of, and it wasn't a sale I had, people coming into a basement and finding snakes in the basement. But you want to spend the time to look for the pests and determine, is the house pest-free? Number seven, which is a big thing, is the area of water damage. As you walk through, and especially walking through your lower level, looking for the iridescent type of things that could be on the block, which shows that maybe there's water that's seeping in or has come in, or looking at the 2x4s that are in the lower level, does it look like that water has come up into the 2x4s? It's as we do these inspections of the property, you can determine, have there been water problems, or looking closely at the ceilings, have there been leaks coming in from the roof? Number eight is the area of faulty electrical or old wiring. I mean, one of the things you're going to want to find is the electrical box and see, what does the electrical box look like? Has it been updated? Does it look in good condition? And as you're down there, how many extra junction boxes are down there? A very big thing to look at, because this is where you can have lots of problems in the house in the future. Number eight is asbestos or even lead. When you look at houses that were built in the 40s through the 70s, you'll see that there are certain kinds of materials that were put into the property that are now considered hazardous and are no longer being built in homes. And you want to see, have things been corrected or taken care of for the safety of your family? And number 10, one of the biggest things that's shown up in our marketplace has been mold. Mold is caused by water, and you've heard of black mold where people have gotten sick in their properties. And so once again, a very big area to look at and red flags to look at as you look at properties. I hope you enjoyed understanding the 10 red flags. And these are important things, and having a good realtor to help you through your process in purchasing a property to bring up the things that could be problems in the potential property that you purchase. Well, thanks so much for watching today, and make it a great day.